Are you guys gonna go eat or something?
We have like the $30. I told her maybe tomorrow we could, if she doesn't.
That poor kid is trying.
Oh, he was such a sweet kid.
For the bride, because you might want to hold on to
it. So hard with the flowers and stuff.
She wanted to take big candles and throw them around.
Charlotte?
Oh, you can nap with me. We're not there for you, Charlotte. Anthony. Oh, he's recording.
There's Precious.
Gives this woman to enjoy with this man in holy matrimony.
I'm
here too.
You may all be seated.
At that point, she was only like 3.
All right, welcome to a windy Apple Valley wedding, right? That's going to be a lot of fun tonight at the celebration. Woo! You've been waiting a while for this, right? And here we are. This is the day. Marion and Lawrence, I'd like to thank you all for being present here to witness their bonding in marriage. We're here to celebrate one of life's greatest moments, the joining of two hearts. In this ceremony today, we'll be joining the lives of Marion and Lawrence in marriage. For them, out of the routine of ordinary life, the extraordinary happened. They met. They fell in love. They're now finalizing it with their vows to each other today. Marion and Lawrence remember that marriage is a precious gift. It's a lifelong dedication to love. A daily challenge to love one another more fully, more freely. Also remember and be mindful that a good relationship never stops growing. Like fine wine, it gets better with age. And as you continue on your journey through life together, I encourage you to contemplate and remember these words of wisdom. Remember that you're never too old to hold hands. Remember to say I love you every day. Remember to give your spouse the same courtesies and kindness you would bestow on your friends. Be sure to always let your love be stronger than your anger. Learn the wisdom of compromise, both them to bend and to break. Never go to sleep angry. Make the choice to forgive and to forgive. And believe the best in your beloved rather than the worst. Speak words of appreciation. Demonstrate gratitude in thoughtful ways. And give unconditional love by accepting each other for who you are. You'll find a good marriage has all these things in common. I hope you will let these words guide you as you live and grow together.
That was your one friend's husband, right?
Well,
boyfriend.
Boyfriend at the
time.
Macy's
all like, I try.
And would you honor the grandmother that passed last evening? She doesn't need the chair because she gets to see from any place she wants. The foundation of a good marriage is love. But it's important to note that love is much more than that wonderful feeling of falling in love. In the Bible, the Apostle Paul wrote about love, and this is what he wrote. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love does not envy. It does not boast. It is not arrogant. It is not rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all, believes all, hopes all, and endures all. Love never fails. Lord, sweetie, now Flint, you never had to interrupt to Marion at this time? Do you, Lord, take Marion to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love, honor, and cherish? And do you promise before God and these witnesses to keep yourself holy unto him, forsaking all others for as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I do. And Marion, will you now pledge your never-ending love to Lawrence at this time? Do you, Marion, take Lawrence to be your husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love, honor, and cherish? And do you promise before God and these witnesses to keep yourself only unto him, forsaking all others for as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I do. So, Lawrence and Marion, remind yourselves often of what brought you here together today. Give the highest priority to the attention, tenderness, and kindness that your marriage deserves. Each of you must take responsibility for the quality of your lives together, and in doing so, your lives will be marked by an abundance of joy and happiness.
God, those trees were tiny.
Now, we are going to attempt the sand ceremony. Yeah. Do we have the stuff?
Wednesday,
yeah, maybe whoever brings the sand out can actually hold on to that.
It's kind of sad because that weekend was not windy.
So then somebody has the colored sands. Okay, go ahead and grab your colors.
You know, it's the desert.
But it's, if you think about the long term, it was better, babe. I was sick. I got really sick.
That's true.
So you may have wanted it on the weekend, but...
Well, I only went on the weekend because, you know...
All right, Lawrence and Marion, today you're making a lifelong commitment to join your separate lives together. These two vials of sand that you hold symbolize your individual separate lives to this moment. Just as you are about to combine the sand, so will your lives be joined together as one. Your relationship is symbolized through the form of these two vials of sand. One representing you, Lawrence, go ahead and pour just a portion of your sand in there. This sand represents all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. And now, Marion, go ahead and put in a portion of your sand. This sand represents all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. Now, you may take turns pouring the sand into the center container. And you can keep taking turns until you run out of sand. As you do so, be mindful that each grain of sand has its own unique beauty, strength, and character. But when they're blended together, they bring to the mixture a lasting beauty that forever enriches the combination. As the remainder of these vials of sand are poured into the vase, the individual vials of sand will no longer exist, but they are now joined together as one. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured back into their individual vials, so will the rough bond between the two of you render you inseparable. You are no longer two, but one, bonded together, forming one heart, one love. Excellent.
husband in the background taking pictures.
It's challenging, but we're getting through it, right? So, it is ring time. So, I'd like to start with the bride's ring first. Do you have the bride's ring? Yeah, go ahead and take that out. The bride's ring, Morris?
Yeah,
I'd like you to place it halfway onto her finger and hold onto it for me. These rings are a symbol of your never-ending love. They are a circle which has no end. Therefore, it is a symbol of infinity. May they mark the beginning of a long journey together. May they remind you both of the commitment you have made to each other today. Lord, as you face Marianne, I'd like you to repeat after me. I give you this ring as a token and a pledge of my love. And with this ring, I take you with my love. I love you with all my heart. Excellent. We'll go ahead and take that blue ring and put it on Lord's finger. Hold on to it and face Lord's for me. Then repeat after me. I give you this ring as a token and a pledge of my love. And with this ring, I take you as my husband. I love you with all that I am. Excellent. You can go on the rest of my life. Alright. Lawrence and Miriam, may this day shine eternally in your lives. May all that is noble, honest, enriching, and beautiful be because this couple is pledged to meet all of life's experiences together and we can find our prayers and joy. In the presence of God and these witnesses, you have each spoken the words and performed the rites which unite your lives together forever. So now, my dear Lord, requesting to me by God and the state of California, I now pronounce you husband and wife.
He knew what time it is.
Yeah, he knew what time it is. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going on with the very first person to be introduced.
Why am I bad? I have no idea. I was nervous.
I know.
Oh, so
nervous.
Hi, everybody.
I'm going to go with the you.
Now you can have a little.
another view of it. You smiled before doing it. You know what you were doing.
Yes, I did. That's why I had you put your piece in my mouth first, babe. Right here is where I started moving energy. I think she really likes rocking too.
Yeah.
I think she'll like,
and this one, I think I was changing.
Yeah, because it was starting to get cold. See, that was a nice part of that. If they wouldn't have torn it up, I would have filed for a title under their deck, and I just got it going.
No, I had you and Josh not fucking off camera.
I
picked
the mirror off.
Freaking Josh in the bathroom.
Alright, so this is going to be the shortest anniversary she has ever done.
Like, yeah,
there's only two couples left. That's what you asked for. So I could just go to 1 year, basically, huh? If you've been married less than 5 years, please sit down.
Just all I call it.
That delivers me immediately. So, how many years have you been?
Does it have when you trip on your butt?
I hope not. I think it does, though. It's so embarrassing.
But you didn't miss it.
I wasn't young like I... See, I thought I was still young in this whole video.
I thought I could drop it low, pick it back up, and I
could not do that. You're barely starting to run. I like the legs they have. I can tell you they feel good.
My energy right here was like almost zero.
Not almost zero, it was zero.
No, I'm still standing, but I have some energy left.
And I don't even know how you got sick.
Me either.
And I just told you the whole time I didn't get sick. That was weird. That really bummed me out though, because I was like, I'm just telling you, we need a wedding to do over. Just saying.
I know, baby. From out to Vegas.
Outtakes.
Oh, this is where you fall on your butt is. You see what Ricky's idea? Instead of putting the ass, just do it like that. Because Ricky is a white dick.
For my freaking thanks, man. It's beautiful. That was my dog. I saw this in the season. There was no fixing that.
And Jess came and she tried to help. Where is I? I think I was inside the house.
I was getting inside like damn near tears because I was told that I couldn't broke and like you guys couldn't get the work down. I was devastated.
And that's Lauren's mom, isn't it?
Yes.
I remember trying to offer her help. There's Joe just like dropping chairs like a genius. You can tell Joe's done that kind of thing before.
Oh my god!
I wish I did though. Father, oh my god. Make me for you not.
Youngest daughter caught it. He's like, you better give that away.
That Pastor Dan was there, and I moved up here.
Yeah.
Did you say you had?
Let's see, 6 racks of ribs, 50 pounds of steak, 60 hot dogs, 60 hamburgers, tri-tip.
Now, what are you going to do with all that extra?
I have no clue.
I think he's coming.
I know, they're gonna test it. It's an outtake. No, they didn't. I win.
I win.